Welcome to a packed Kittatinny Regional High School in Hampton, New Jersey, as Muggs Media presents the High School Wrestling Match of the Week. It's the Backyard Brawl, the one match everyone that loves wrestling in Sussex County puts it on their calendar when they see the schedule come out, as it's the Kittatinny Cougars who come in with a record of 14-4, just newly minted Colonial Division champs under their legendary coach John Gill, host the High Point Wildcats, who come in a record of 13-4 after wrapping up the Freedom Division, and they're led by a fellow Sussex County legend, John Gardner. Good evening, everyone. Thanks for joining us here on Channel 10 and MuggsMedia.com, one of our favorite sporting events to cover on the school year docket, and it is here. And we want to thank the following sponsors: Orthopedic Institute in New Jersey, Medical Park Imaging, Pope John High School, Family Ford and Necon, our scoreboard sponsor, Visible Difference Hair Salon in Sparta, A&B Bagels in Andover, Home Furniture Warehouse, Jesse Rowe, huge supporter of high school wrestling, located in Newton, Double S Diner, Double S Smokehouse, Guy's Affordable Auto Sales, located in Newton, Tim's Auto and Truck Repair in Sussex, Lorenzo's Pizza in Sussex, and we also want to thank tonight CPA and attorney Bill Keough. Tax season's coming up. Give him a call at 579-3390. Bill's a big supporter of High Point Athletics. Garden State Koi, the Tri-State's largest water garden superstore, your one-stop shop for all your pond needs. Call the Smith family, 845-651-4100. The Smith's a big supporter of High Point Athletics. We also want to thank the Fall Guys. Spring is around the corner for all your cleanup. Call the Fall Guys, 973-221-3331. And also special sponsors for tonight's Wingle Supply, a big supporter of High Point Wrestling. Call Wingle Supply today at 973-875-7170. And Bill Moynihan of Stiefel Investments in Sukasauna, he wishes the Kittatinny Cougars the best of luck tonight and the rest of the season. Call Bill today at 973-598-8300. Good evening, everyone. I'm Dan Cleary. This is one of the best matchups we see every year in any sport. These two schools have been going at it since 1976, with High Point holding a 27-13-1 edge. They've won 9 of the last 11 matches between these two schools. Kittatinny won last year 38-23, and they will look to make it 2 in a row. Going to bring in my partner, former Kittatinny wrestler and coach, Nick DeGennaro. Nick, you're a veteran of this as a wrestler, as a coach, as a member of the media. This is a great night for Sussex County Wrestling.
Yeah, it is. And out of all of those, this is probably my favorite spot because there's no pressure whatsoever. Unfortunately, as a wrestler, we weren't even in their class when I was here other than my freshman year. We tied them. Other than that, it was 3 years of taking a beating. And coaching, you know, went back and forth. And there was a nice streak that we finished on when I was here and got out when the getting was good. But it is as intense a rivalry as any in Sussex County. You probably have Sparta Pope John football, and then you have this. It's the best wrestling matchup possible. Historically, the two best programs. You'll get other programs that are good, but these two are consistently at the top. And where there used to be a true dislike, and I think there still is among the fans, I think now you get more mutual respect between the teams and the coaches.
It's just a great night. And now with Sparta and Pope John not playing each other in football, this goes to the top in my book as the best rivalry around. Now these two teams coming off division titles the other night, High Point beating Newton, Kittatinny beating Pacon. These two teams pretty well matched. Any certain matches you see tonight that might be the key to victory for either team?
Well, the interesting thing of High Point is they've weighed in. Their guys up a weight class starting at 113. They have Devin Flannery is up at 120. Maverick Liebel is at 126. Billy Talmadge at 132. That move is probably to cover up and take R.J. Bravoe out of the lineup and try and take out Perry Mayo. But by having Flannery at 120, it keeps Kittatinny from moving Mark DiGeronimo up to 126. So that's going to change things a little bit. That does open an opportunity for Kittatinny at 113. Mike Nelson's been wrestling very well. He had a nice win the other night against Parsippany. So that's going to be a good battle, him and Devin Liebel. And I think when you get up top, if Kittatinny can get the matchups that they want to get Zach Mafaro, who's weighed in at 220 today. They want to get him on Cliff Rutter. If they can get that matchup, then they're going to be happy. But this match is going to be decided right in that 145, 152, 160 range. There and always, who can minimize the amount of bonus points they give up? They always swing the balance in this. And I think this could be similar to 2 years ago where it was a 32-31 match. It's going to be a toss-up of who's going to win, and I'm excited. This is going to be a really fun. It's going to be a super intense atmosphere, and this is what we do this for, and this is why these kids want to wrestle. And you couldn't have a better match for these two teams to get ready for the state sectionals.
Without a doubt, state sectionals start next week. Both teams are respective number one seeds. Kittatinny in North 1, Group 1. High Point in North 1, Group 2. So as we have the introductions, we're going to head into a commercial break. We'll be back with the beginning of the Backyard Brawl.
This wrestling match is being sponsored by attorney and CPA Bill Kehoe, located on Route 206 in Branchville. Make sure you're up to date on all the latest tax law. Call Bill Kehoe today for all your tax law questions at 973-579-3390.
This game is being sponsored by Highland State Bank, your local community bank. Visit their Sparta branch on Sparta Avenue in Sparta. Start that college fund today at Highland State Bank. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
The new paver driveway.
Jim! Relax. These are CST monocast one-piece pavers.
Some pavers only have a thin layer of color sealed on top. But with CST monocast pavers, the strength and color goes all the way through. The color won't wear away. So your CST pavers will look just as beautiful 20 years from now.
Unlike Jim.
CST pavers. Discover the difference.
Wingle Supply is your winter headquarters for salt, ice melt, or pellet fuel. Wingle Supply, located 755 Route 565 in Augusta, 973-875-7170. This game made possible by Garden State Koi. They are the pond guys in the tri-state area, leaders in pond, stream, and waterfall design, installation, and maintenance. Call Tom Smith, 845-651-4100. And a special thanks to the Smith family for sponsoring this game. This game of the week is sponsored by Bill Moynihan of Stiefel. Let Bill Moynihan help you pursue your financial goals. Contact Bill Moynihan at the Stiefel office in Roxbury at 973-598-8312 or email him moynihanw@stiefel.com. Stiefel, celebrating 125 years of helping investors pursue their financial goals.
Furniture is a reflection of you, your personality, your lifestyle. Hi, I'm Jesse Rowe from Home Furniture Warehouse.
Celebrate the new year with savings at Home Furniture Warehouse. Shop our New Year's sale now through January 11th. Save 15% off floor models, save 10% off special orders. And with new clearance items added daily, our pricing and selection are worth falling for.
Stop by Home Furniture Warehouse in Newton, your local furniture savings destination for over 20 years.
The Russo family are proud owners of two local businesses. Visible Difference is located on Woodport Road in Sparta and is your hometown salon. You will really see the Visible Difference, a full-service hair, skin, and nail salon. Call for an appointment today, 973-729-4338. The best bagels in Sussex County are found at A&B Bagels Deli and Grill. Get a great hearty breakfast and lunch. Everything is homemade at A&B Bagels. Call your order or stop into A&B Bagels, located in Newton and Randolph. Call them 973-579-8777.
Family Ford, your local hometown dealership on the Circle in Netcog. Family Ford supplies t-shirts for local high schools in Sussex and in Morris counties. Family Ford has a great selection of new and used cars and trucks. Become one of the family. Shop at Family Ford on Netcong Circle in Netcong.
Hello, this is Father McHugh, Director of the Catholic Academy of Sussex County. The Academy providing excellence in education and a faith-filled environment for all of our students in grades pre-K through 12 has moved to one campus at the corner of Andover Road and Sparta Avenue in Sparta. We offer an easy transition for our students as they journey through elementary, middle, and high school education. The Reverend George A. Brown Memorial School has been repurposed to meet the needs of our younger students in grades pre-K through 4. The new Pope John XXIII Middle School, unique in the Diocese of Paterson, offers a true middle school environment for our students in grades 5, 6, and 7. And Pope John Regional High School, grades 8 through 12, continues to focus on college preparation and offers a full complement of 134 courses on 3 levels. We invite you to be a part of the Academy family. Contact Ann Kaiser in admissions today at 973-729-6125 and extension 255 to schedule a visit in any of our schools. Our doors are always open.
Medical Park Imaging is a multi-modality imaging center with 3 locations. Medical Park Imaging is committed to your health and uses only the best equipment that technology has to offer. Medical Park Imaging has on-site physicians who are certified in radiology. Medical Park Imaging supports high school sports in Sussex and Morris counties. Medical Park Imaging with 3 locations, Wayne, Denville, and Newfoundland. This game is being sponsored in part by the best diner in Sussex County, the Double S Diner on Route 23 in Wantage, where the portions are huge and the prices are small. A longtime staple in Sussex Borough is Lorenzo's Pizza. Great Italian food, huge sub sandwiches, great pizza, open 7 days a week. Lorenzo's Pizza. Come on by for lunch or dinner, or call your order in and pick it up. It'll be ready when you get there. Lorenzo's Pizza is a big supporter of high school sports in Northwest New Jersey, and they welcome all athletic teams to order from them. Lorenzo's Pizza, 973-875-5055.
Welcome back to Kittatinny Regional High School. And that tells the whole story of Kittatinny Wrestling right there, folks. Look at all those state championship banners. 8 in total, John Gill with over 500 career wins. Johnny Gardner with over 300 wins. This is the best night in Sussex County Wrestling. Thanks for joining us, I'm Dan Cleary. We want to thank Wingle Supply, the Fall Guys, as well as Bill Moynihan of Stiefel Investments, Garden State Coy, and Bill Kehoe, and we're gonna get underway at 220 pounds. As High Point sends out Cliff Rutter.
And Zach Mafaro for Kittatinny. Now Kittatinny wanted this matchup.
And let's get it on. And we are underway here in Hampton.
Now Zach Mafaro had to gain weight to make this weight class. He weighed in 199. And Cliff Rutter just walked in and weighed 219. So he's gonna have a 20-pound advantage, and in reality, it's probably gonna be more like a 25-pound advantage because that's not Zach Mafaro's natural weight.
Mafaro 22-5, Cliff Rutter 13-4. Wanna thank our friend Mike Wildman for supplying a lot of the information you'll be hearing tonight. Mike's outstanding blog, Open Mike. So want to give credit where credit's due. Thank you, Mike. Mike in here in attendance tonight.
Mike is the quintessential wrestling gym rat.
Yes, indeed.
And you want to know the history of any wrestling program in North Jersey, Mike Weilman's your source.
No score here in the first period, just under a minute to go.
Now, one of the things that Mafaro's going to have to do is use his athleticism. He arguably could be the best athlete that hits a wrestling match in Sussex County this year. Just a tremendous three-sport athlete. Rutter is going to have the strength advantage and a big headlock.
And a big point for Mafaro, the takedown. He's got Rutter in trouble, 40 seconds. Rutter trying to fight it off with the face rake. Mafaro's got that headlock tight. 18 seconds, can Rutter hold him off? And he can't. A pin for Zach LaFaro. Huge pin as Kittatinny will take the 6-0 lead. What a start for the Cougars, Nick.
You couldn't start any better for Kittatinny, and you couldn't start any worse for a High Point right there. One thing High Point, when they beat Kittatinny, they do not give up bonus points.
Well, Kittatinny gets a huge 6 points as Mafaro gets the headlock and the pin.
Chris Letterio for Kittatinny and Tom Hubmaster at heavyweight now.
So with that 6 points right off the bat, the heavyweight match becomes even more important for High Point.
Absolutely. Hubmaster is going to have a weight advantage here. And again, Letterio, Kittatinny will probably have the athlete advantage here. Letterio, very good athlete for Kittatinny. Very good baseball player here at Kittatinny.
Also came on strong in football at the end of the year, getting some time on the D-line.
Yeah, he came out late for football. He had started the season in a cross-country team.
Yes.
And came out for football.
So the pin for Zach Mafaro at 146. Hubmaster on top here against Letterio. And that early pin got this packed gym going crazy early on. Hubmaster 12-8, Letterio 10-8, an escape for Letterio.
And this is where Hubmaster's gonna have to use, he's gonna have the size advantage. He can try to wear Letterio down. The longer this match goes, I think the better off Hubmaster's gonna be.
A 108 to go here in the first period. Hubmaster with the 2-0 lead. Thanks for joining us here on Channel 10 at MuggsMedia.com. Dan Cleary along with Nick DeGennaro.
Hubmaster has a 39-pound weight advantage here. Because that weight advantage doesn't help you right now, but anytime you get on top, and that's what happened, Letterio got underneath him, and Hubmaster was able to take advantage of it.
Well, a great start for Kittatinny with Zach Mafaro, despite being outweighed. With the big headlock and throw and pins Cliff Rutter. So if you're just joining us, it's already been an action-packed match.
And, you know, no surprise there, really. I think Zach Mafaro is one of the most exciting young athletes in Sussex County.
Hubmaster with
another
two.
Another nice pass by for a takedown.
And Letterio will pick up the escape. 2 seconds to go. And the first period will come to an end with Tom Hubmaster holding a 4-2 lead.
Zach Mafaro, just getting back in for a moment. This year finished just 20 yards short of being a 1,000-yard rusher as a sophomore for the Kittatinny football team. He'll also be going back to track this year. He was playing baseball last year. And I think he and his brother are going to rival their uncle Jay, who was a state champion in the javelin. They're going to be two tremendous track athletes. And Letterio trying to work a Merkel there. And now draping over for a cradle, and Hubmaster almost pulling him off.
Hubmaster trying to get out. Thirty seconds into the second period, 4-2, Hubmaster with the lead.
Letterio put himself in danger.
He certainly did, but the only thing will come out of it with 1 point for now. Hubmaster with the 5-2 lead.
They were one of those situations with the big guys where it's the first guy to step in front wins. And usually he doesn't just win the takedown, he wins the match.
Right.
Because when these big guys go on their back, they don't get off it too often.
It's the old turtle syndrome. Yeah. Hubmaster with a 3-point lead, 1:10 to go.
The difference is when the turtle goes on his back, he doesn't usually have another turtle laying on top of him. It makes it even harder.
Let's go, 35 seconds to go. Big guys just feeling each other out right now. And we'll head back to the middle. Placentario having some issues with his headgear.
The fans yelling for Stalling. High Point fans, I should say.
Yes.
Again, that's why it's better to be over here, right? Behind the announcer's table. At least when they swear at me now, I have headphones on, I can't hear it.
There you go. I'll make sure I don't swear at you with these on. 30 seconds to go. Check that, 19 seconds.
Dan learning how difficult it is to see the clock here. Kittatinny, that backboard in the way.
And the second period is going to come to an end with Hubmaster holding a three-point lead. 5-2.
Now, cool. Letterio will have his choice. He's probably going to take bottom.
And we've talked about this in previous High Point matches. Not a bad guy to coach the upper weights, Billy Smith over there. In his first year as an assistant coach, former state champ, tremendous career at Rutgers.
Yeah, and you're a big guy. You got to know you're coming to practice to work hard every day.
Oh, yeah.
Coach Smith is going to be the guy that's going to be on top of you, making you work hard.
Letterio trying to get out. As we'll head off the mat, no points awarded.
I think Letterio would be better off really looking for the reversal. He hasn't been able to get close to a takedown on the feet. And a lot of times with the big guys, the reversal becomes a two-plus situation because you usually put the other guy on his back.
Hubmaster riding Letterio, trying to get the ankle for a moment.
Hubmaster doing a good job of keeping that pressure on Letterio. Letterio keeps looking for that elbow roll, but Hubmaster's keeping himself in good position.
No stall warnings yet for either wrestler.
You can hear the stalling calls coming from the Kittatinny crowd now. You hear that?
And there it is.
And that's going to be on Chris Letterio.
No points awarded, just the warning. And as Nick pointed out, it's on Letterio. 50 seconds to go.
Hubmaster doing a good job trying to work for that cross arm and keeping the pressure on the front side of Letterio, not allowing him to get a base under himself.
Trying to lock up the cradle here. He's a little high.
Oh, he might put himself to his own back.
Yes, he gets back. Wow.
Wow is right.
Little face mush there from Hubmaster.
I'm not sure how many gray hairs Johnny Gardner has, but he just spread out two more.
20 seconds to go. And we'll have another stall warning. And it will be a point. So it'll be 6-2 for Tommy Hubmaster. And he's going to pick up the victory and get High Point on the scoreboard.
A nice job by Hubmaster. That was a big win that High Point needed to have.
He'll pull it to 6-3 victory, and High Point will get its first win of the evening as he's greeted by Johnny Gardner and Billy Smith. And now we'll head to 106 pounds, and we'll see who comes out for Kittatinny. It looks like
Tippy Malfetto, yep.
Derek Malfetto will come out, better known as Tippy. This should be LaRue for High Point. Brandon LaRue, he's having a great year as a sophomore, 22-2. Malfetto, also a sophomore, 14-12. And right off the bat, LaRue deep into his shot, but a good job by Malfetto to hold him off. We'll have a stalemate.
High Point will be heavily favored here. Malfetto has struggled of late.
It just seems like Kittatinny has an endless supply of Malfettos.
There's another one coming. Tippy's younger brother, Craig, I believe is an eighth grader.
So LaRue, 22-2, having a great year. As Nick pointed out, will be counted on to pick up some points, bonus points here for the Wildcats. They trail 6-3.
And while Tippy has struggled lately, I've had the pleasure of coaching him. He's a tough kid. He's not big, but he's got a big heart. So I know John Gill's going to count on him to try to, if he can't win, at least minimize the points he gives up. But LaRue's a heavy favorite here.
And Malfetto showing that toughness you talked about, Nick. Making LaRue work for everything right here. No points awarded yet.
And yeah, nice finish by LaRue. Malfetto did a nice job fighting that, but LaRue with a great finish.
LaRue up top. He has a 2-0 lead over Malfetto.
Of course, High Point, this is the first time we've seen them sporting the 50th anniversary singlets tonight.
Yes. I was going to bring that up. Good point, Nick. And the first period is going to come to an end with LaRue holding the 2-0 lead. And you go all the way back to Butchie Ansbach starting the program. Butch was a football guy, went to Newton High School, knew the value of wrestling. And him along with a bunch of parents said, you know what, High Point needs to have wrestling. He started the program, ran it for a few years before Jeff Hull came in, the Sussex County Hall of Famer, and put High Point on the map in wrestling.
Both these programs, perennial powers.
And all of the offspring of Newton Wrestling.
Yes. So people ever wonder, how did High Point win, or how did Newton win so many state champions for years? Remember, these kids were all wrestling for Newton.
That's
well,
right.
Well, their ancestors were.
No flags yet. And Malfetto, again, as Nick pointed out, showing that toughness.
But he's going to have to find a way to score some points because
right.
Right now he's not showing enough. He's probably pretty close to picking up a stall call. So he's going to have to create a little bit more. LaRue's doing a nice job trying to set up that tilt. He got one flag and one flag again. He did not get two.
So no points awarded yet. 55 seconds to go here in the second period.
There weren't many moves in my career I did well, but this is one. LaRue's got to get more perpendicular on the tilt. He's too parallel. It's hard to tilt the guy when you're parallel with him. Like they say, man needs to know his limitations. I know my two good moves, and it was one.
Again, LaRue in control.
Trying to feed that arm through the crotch right now.
17 seconds to go, second period. Less than 10. Not much doing here. And the second period is going to come to an end with Brandon LaRue with a 2-0 lead over Tippy Malfetto.
LaRue will have his choice. He'll take bottom.
Again, I want to thank Bill Moynihan of Stiefel Investments in Sukasana. He wishes Kittatinny Wrestling the best of luck tonight and the rest of the season. Call Bill for all your financial needs, 973-598-8300. And Wingle Supply, a big supporter of high school wrestling at High Point. Call Wingle Supply, 973-875-7170.
Now you see a difference in style on bottom. You see LaRue with a lot more movement. Malfetto's got a leg in, and I know right now Chunk Hill does not want him to have a leg in here. The Kittatinny rule was you never throw legs on High Point. And that's why.
And LaRue will pick up the two with the reversal. He'll push his lead to 4-0.
Now the question is, will LaRue stay on the mat? I really think he's better off just letting Malfetto go and getting the takedowns. It's too easy to stall on the bottom. He's trying to work that crossface cradle right here.
Agreed. I'm sure High Point's looking for more than just three here.
Kittatinny would be more than happy to get out of this match, only giving up 3 points.
We're under a minute to go. Third period. LaRue with the 4-0 lead.
And I know the High Point fans are yelling for a stall, but LaRue's really on the hip a lot and very parallel. He's not in position to get the stall. He's got to come out the side more. And you can see he's starting to get a little frustrated. He's putting a little extra on the cross faces. So LaRue's got to be careful, because the last thing you want to do here is pick up a penalty point.
And again, in big matches, Nick, we talk about it all the time. It's not the matches you win. It's how you lose the matches.
Yes.
Keeping the bonus points off the scoreboard.
Or getting the bonus points.
Correct.
That High Point pin to win against Hanover Park, legendary for bonus points.
The best I've ever seen.
And there's the stall call, and it's deserved.
Yes.
Malfetto was hanging on to the hands. That's the one thing that gets the stall call right away. And he'll gladly give up two more stall calls because it won't make a difference in the score.
Potentially dangerous. We'll start again.
And that's why I had a question, LaRue staying on with a minute 20 on a 4-0 score.
13 seconds to go here in the third.
Caution on Malfetto.
Well, High Point's going to pick up points here, but Tippy Malfetto did his job.
So far, Dan, you remember Hobie Wanamaker?
This is true.
A lot can happen in a short amount of time.
And the buzzer will sound, so LaRue will post a 4-0 victory. We're tied at 6, but more importantly, Kittatinny does not give up bonus points at 106, as we'll move to 113, one of the matches that Nick pointed to at the beginning of the match.
That'll be Mike Nelson for Kittatinny.
It'll be Maverick Liebel for High Point.
Devin Liebel.
And Kyle Nelson for High Point. Devin Liebel picks up the takedown to start the match. Limited matches this year, the freshman 4-1. And Mike Nelson 10-10. So we're gonna see Flannery at 120 most likely, right, Nick?
I would think so. Because High Point can't afford to send out someone else.
Well, Lyville's got it locked up here. He's got Nelson in trouble. Almost had it there. Nelson will roll out of it. He'll pick up the back points. So Devin Lyville will get the 3 back points. He'll have a 5-0 lead. He'll give up the escape. 5-1 is our score.
And you can see that underhook. And the underhook leads to the dump.
Lee will go up 7-1.
And I'm sure John Gill is telling his entire team right now, what are you putting that under in the football? You don't have to put that underhook in there. If you could ever put a microphone on John Gill on the sideline, that would be gold. It'd have a lot of bleeps in it, but it would be gold.
Well, it's worked 547 times.
Yeah.
As we're under 15 seconds to go in a very active first period for Devin Liebel, the freshman, with the 7-1 lead over Mike Nelson. He had Nelson in trouble, but he got out of it.
Great start by Liebel. And you can see he's just a little bit, he's more physical than Mike Nelson right now. Nelson, who did miss time with an elbow injury this year. Leba will take feet.
So second period underway. Thanks for joining us here in the Mugs Media Match of the Week. The Backyard Brawl, Kittatinny High Point Wrestling, Dan Cleary, along with Nick DiGennaro. Packed house here at Kittatinny. Gotta love it.
Another underhook and another dump.
He'll go up 9-1 after the reversal. Again, I want to thank Bill Kehoe, attorney CPA, located in Route 206 in Augusta. Tax season coming up. Also want to thank the Fall guys. And Liebel got one flag. And I want to thank Garden State Coy, Route 94 Warwick, the Smith family, big supporter of High Point Athletics. And he'll get another two. Pushes lead to 11-1. 105 to go second period.
Did a nice belly bar. And Nelson did a nice job really countering it. When he got over, Liebel kept him from turning the way that he wanted to turn, which would have put Liebel in trouble.
11-2 our score. 55 seconds to go, second period.
Nelson with the underhook again. He changed this one out pretty quickly.
Right now, High Point, if it stays this way, would get bonus points, but they're looking for six. 13-2.
At this point, Kittatinny might be happy with a tech fall. Save 1 point, possibly. Liebel just appears to have way too much for Nelson.
And we've seen this match come down to 1 point before.
Just 2 years ago.
In the state tournament. And the second period's gonna come to an end.
Now, if I'm Kittatinny, I choose feet. I don't take bottom. I would choose feet. He's gonna take top, but I would have taken feet.
Devin Liebel with a commanding 15-2 lead, 13-point advantage.
And you're probably thinking, Nick, you choose feet, it gets taken down, it's tech fall. Yeah, that's why you choose feet, because you don't want to risk getting pinned. At this point, a five-pointer is not a bad loss. You can look at it as you've saved a point. On the mat, Liebel's deadly down here. Now maybe Mike Nelson can hit a cradle or something here and prove me wrong.
Nelson's thinking, let's keep it to four.
Well, he's trying to win the match. And right, I don't blame the kid for that at all. He's making a choice he needs to make as a wrestler. I think they're going to call it illegal head scissor, but I didn't see Mike's feet cross, but they must have.
So a 14-point advantage, 16-2. Liebel.
Nelson trying for the Merkel.
Liebel trying to fight it off. Nice shot by Nelson.
He only got one flag, though. Nice shot by Liebel. Though he did the wrong thing. He stood up in him. Oh, and a cradle.
Great job by Nelson.
This could be a 16-2. Huge turnaround.
He's got Liebel in trouble for the moment. And he'll pick up the back points.
But now Liebel's going to possibly take Nelson to his back.
16-5 our score.
Nelson not giving up. He's trying to lock this cradle back up again.
Boy, what a turn of events that would be.
We talked about the heart of Tippy Malfetto. How about the heart of Mike Nelson?
No doubt. Down 16-2. Yeah,
16-2.
Nelson with 15 seconds to go.
He locked up the cradle again.
Can he finish it off? 7 seconds.
Even if he doesn't finish it off, this is a major decision. The coaching staff's going to be very happy with Mike Nelson.
And Nelson will lose but it's almost a victory for the Cougars. Great win for Devin Weibel. Don't want to take anything away from him as he posts a 16-4 major.
He did a tremendous job fighting off his back.
And High Point will take a 10-6 lead.
Devin Flannery and Niall Matar.
So obviously Flannery's going to be looking for six here for High Point. Flannery 17-2. Niall Matar 8-15. I mean, a great job by Nelson, but great job by Lively. I mean, according to the records, only his sixth match of the year. And he came out and did a great job. Picked up four.
And he fought off his back at the end to not only maintain the major decision, but not give up bonus points to Kittatinny.
So High Point will take the 10-6 lead. Obviously a big favorite here with Flannery. Flannery will pick up the two. Now, both of these teams, Nick, have wrestled great non-league schedules. And look at that reversal.
Niall Matar is one of the stronger 120-pounders around. The big thing for Matar is confidence. He doesn't always wrestle with confidence. Flannery will be able to outclass him with skill, but if he underestimates Matar, he could be in trouble. And this might be the place.
Three.
This might be the place for Flannery to wrestle Matar up on the feet.
These teams have a couple of common opponents. One, Wes Morris, that Kittatinny beat a couple weeks ago, and Wes Morris beat High Point in December. I think that might be a different outcome if they wrestled again, to be honest. But Flannery trying to get Matar to his back.
He'll definitely pick up back points, and Matar's not out of danger yet.
30 seconds to go here in the first period. Does he have him? High Point thinks he does, and he gets the pin. So High Point will increase his lead to 16-6.
Mark D. Geronimo will come out for Kittatinny now.
Flannery will get the pin in 137. We move to 126 pounds. As Nick said, D. Geronimo for High Point. Excuse me, Kittatinny.
And Maverick Liebel.
And Maverick Liebel, as Nick said, will come out for High Point. And right away, D. Geronimo's got Maverick Liebel in trouble. DeGeronimo.
Oh, he's got him.
It looks like he's got him. Great answer here by Kittatinny if he's able to get the fall.
That's why Kittatinny made the switch. They knew they might be giving up six. They figure they're giving up six at 120. They're hoping to get six back here. They put DeGeronimo out against Flannery. Could be a good match. DeGeronimo's probably get the advantage. But he's probably not going to get many bonus points, if any, on Flannery. And then they're going to give up bonus points at 126.
So good job by Maverick Liebel, who comes into this match 14-5. Mark DeGeronimo, 16-4 for Kittatinny. As he holds him off here in the first period for the moment, DeGeronimo builds up the 5-1 lead.
And a great job by Liebel getting off his back. I thought he was done there.
Looked like it. Very close. DeGeronimo putting the pressure on Liebel. Trying to work his way around Liebel with the arm. 19 seconds to go, first period. DeGeronimo in deep. 3 seconds, no points awarded. And the first period will come to an end with DeGeronimo holding a 5-1 lead. Again, want to thank Wingle Supply. Give them a call, 973-875-7170. Bill Moynihan of Stiefel Investments, 973-598-8300. Attorney and CPA Bill Keough, it's tax season. He's located on Route 206 in Augusta. Call Bill today for all your tax needs, 973-579-3390. The Fall Guys, for your spring cleanups right around the corner, we'll have a warning, 973-221-3331. As well as we want to thank our regular sponsors, Orthopedic Institute New Jersey, Pope John High School, Medical Park Imaging, Family Ford of Netcon, our scoreboard sponsor, Visible Difference Hair Salon, A&B Bagels, Double S Diner, Double S Smokehouse, Home Furniture Warehouse, Jesse Rowe here tonight watching the match. Thanks for him for many years of support of high school wrestling. Guys, Affordable Auto Sales, Tim's Auto and Truck Repair, and Lorenzo's Pizza. And we'll get to pick up the point here. 5-2 our score. So High Point with the 10-point lead. As we're in our sixth match of the evening, nearing the midway point, and DeGeronimo's got Lebo in trouble. And he gets the pin. Big pin for Mark DeGeronimo. And Kittatinny picks up the six, and they trail by four, 16-12. Big win, big points there for the Cougars, Nick.
And that's why they make the move. They put Matar out at 120, because the 6-6 is better than any other combination they could have gotten.
And the fall is in 244. So we'll move to 132.
Billy Talmadge for High Point, Perry Mayo for Kittatinny.
The freshman for High Point against a tough Perry Mayo, very scrappy. Talmadge 15-7 overall. Perry Mayo 13-11. So Talmadge having a promising freshman year against a very daunting schedule, 15 wins. As the fans start to get fired up, but in a very respectful way.
At least what we can hear is.
Well, Chris Carroll does a great job here at crowd control. Some other wrestlers from around the county here tonight. Jake Brown from Pope John sitting here, front row.
He lives in the Kittatinny School District.
So Mark DeGeronimo in the previous match in 126 with the big pin over Maverick Liebel. We have a 4-point match, 16-12, as we are at the midway point, our seventh match of the evening. What has made Talmadge successful this year, coming out as a freshman at a tough weight class? You've seen him wrestle a few times.
Yeah, well, first of all, you see he's pretty well put together for a freshman. He's got a ton of ability. I mean, when you add that and you got the horsepower to go along with the moves, that makes you tough. And he's got you can tell he wrestles with confidence. And that is such a huge issue in sports today, and especially high school athletics. I think it's something that can never be overstated. And it's easy when you're outside saying, well, that kid's good, he should be confident. Yeah, but the key part of what you just said was that kid.
Right.
You know, you're trying to find your way in life, nonetheless, whatever sport it is. So being fully confident in yourself as a person, as a student athlete, you know, that's not that common.
You had a bad day in class, didn't do well on a test, it might carry over to the mat.
Just in general, this sport's a grind. You know, one or two match losing streak feels like it's a month sometimes.
You feel like, when am I going to win again?
Yeah, and you start to doubt yourself, and now your moves are a little slower. You don't do things with full confidence. And, you know, one or two losses become four or five losses, and next thing you know, you don't think you can win a match, and you can go downhill in a hurry. It's really hard to build it back up again. And you know what? It's sometimes in the regular team sports, your teammate can pick you up. Nobody can pick you up when you're out here on the mat. All you. And a great claw by Talmadge, not able to turn it. The one thing you don't want to do when he's got that claw is stand up. And Perry Mello keeps standing up. You've got to take it off before you stand up. It gives all the leverage in the world. And if Lebo gets deep in along that underwear line, he's going to send Mayo right to his back.
So still no score here. Second period, we're 30 seconds in. 132-pound match. Mayo, nice job to fight it off. And he'll pick up the point.
Mayo is an excellent defensive wrestler. I don't know where he's going to find the offense to take Talmadge down unless Talmadge makes a mistake. But Talmadge is going to find it's going to be very difficult to finish anything on Perry Mayo. And Mayo has had success against High Point in dual meets. But again, High Point makes this move because they need to win this weight class. If Talmadge stays at 26s, DeGeronimo stays at 20s, they could lose 20s and 32s. Here, they might win 20s and 32s.
So we'll come back to the middle of the mat. 46 seconds to go.
Trust me, on each of these benches, there's a coach that has a notepad that has every combination figured out.
Right.
It's on there. All right, if we weigh in this way, it does this. If they weigh in this way, it does that. And everybody has the same rule. All right, I figure worst case scenario for us. And you go through and Lynn Cron used to fill up a pad.
I was just
going to
say, I heard he was the best.
By far the best. Having worked with him and seen him do it, it's amazing. You learn from the best. Oh, nice pancake. And nothing.
No points awarded. 2 seconds to go in the period.
Great job by Mayo.
Absolutely. Ooh. Perry Mayo doing what Nick said he does well, defensive wrestling. We're going to go through the third period, and he holds a 1-0 lead.
And actually, Talmadge takes feet. That's a surprise. Perry Mayo is not known as a world beater on top. We've yet to see Talmadge take bottom this year. Every time we've seen him, he's taking feet. And that's tough. He had that 1-point loss to Fellini, maybe being on bottom. But Fellini is a top, tough guy on top. Mayo is not generally regarded as a tough rider. So I'm surprised by that. But I was surprised Mike Nelson took top, and look, he shut me up.
Edge of the mat, Talmadge trying to keep Perry Mayo in, and they're off. We'll head back to the middle. John Gardner, the great coach at High Point, giving the instructions, and as Nick pointed out in our previous match, his alma mater winning the national title in football, Clemson. Talmadge in deep. Nothing yet. Perry Mayo holding him off.
Mayo's going to get two out of this.
Yes, he is.
He's going to get two.
And he does.
If Mayo can pull this off, High Point's in a lot of trouble.
Agreed.
They're going to need some upsets coming up. Looking at this, I gave this matchup to High Point if they weighed in this way. High Point fans yelling for a stall.
38 seconds to go. Perry Mayo with a 3-0 lead over Billy Talmadge. Mayo, a junior, but a veteran. He's seen a lot of mat time for the Cougars. He's just got to be smart now.
And he's got no stall warnings.
No.
So he can really just kill time. And he'd be silly not to. The pressure's on Talmadge.
Stalemate, 20 seconds to go. Warning.
I'll tell you what, right now, I would pay money to put a Fitbit on John Gill because he's got 5,000 steps in just in this match.
Well, Perry Mayo on his way, possibly, to picking up a huge win here, but Talmadge going to get out almost, trying to get the one and possibly the switch. 7 seconds. And Mayo takes him back to the mat.
He's going to fight off this Peterson, and he does. Huge win for Perry Mayo.
Mayo with a 3-0 victory over Talmadge. Huge win for the junior as he cuts High Point's lead to 16-15. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back.
This game of the week is being sponsored by Villa Capri Pizza in Sparta, just around the corner from Pope John. Come in for a full meal or just a slice. Call them at 973-729-6654. This wrestling match is being sponsored by attorney and CPA Bill Kehoe, located on Route 206 in Branchville. Make sure you're up to date on all the latest tax law. Call Bill Kehoe today for all your tax law questions at 973-579-3390.
This game made possible by Garden State Koi. They are the pond guys in the tri-state area, leaders in pond, stream, and waterfall design, installation, and maintenance. Call Tom Smith, 845-651-4100. And a special thanks to the Smith family for sponsoring this game.
The new paver driveway.
Jim! Relax. These are CST monocast one-piece pavers.
Some pavers only have a thin layer of color sealed on top. But with CST monocast pavers, the strength and color goes all the way through. The color won't wear away. So your CST pavers will look just as beautiful 20 years from now.
Unlike Jim.
CST pavers. Discover the difference.
Wingle Supply is your winter headquarters for salt, ice melt, or pellet fuel. Wingle Supply, located 755 Route 565 in Augusta, 973-875-7170. This game is being sponsored by Highland State Bank, your local community bank. Visit their Sparta branch on Sparta Avenue in Sparta. Start that college fund today at Highland State Bank. Equal housing lender, member FDIC.
The Russo family are proud owners of two local businesses. Visible Difference is located on Woodport Road in Sparta and is your hometown salon. You will really see the Visible Difference, a full-service hair, skin, and nail salon. Call for an appointment today, 973-729-4338. The best bagels in Sussex County are found at A&B Bagels Deli and Grill. Get a great hearty breakfast and lunch. Everything is homemade at A&B Bagels. Call your order or stop into A&B Bagels, located in Newton and Randolph. Call them 973-579-8777.
Franklin Suss's Auto Body, the official body shop of Muggs Media, Route 23 in Hamburg. Give Andrew a call at 827-1676.
Furniture is a reflection of you, your personality, your lifestyle. Hi, I'm Jesse Rowe from Home Furniture Warehouse.
Celebrate the new year with savings at Home Furniture Warehouse. Shop our New Year's sale now through January 11th. Save 15% off floor models, save 10% off special orders, and with new clearance items added daily, our pricing and selection are worth falling for.
Stop by Home Furniture Warehouse in Newton, your local furniture savings destination for over 20 years.
Family Ford, your local hometown dealership on the Circle of Netcog. Family Ford supplies t-shirts for local high schools in Sussex and in Morris counties. Family Ford has a great selection of new and used cars and trucks. Become one of the family. Shop at Family Ford on Metcalf Circle in Netcong. Medical Park Imaging is a multi-modality imaging center with three locations. Medical Park Imaging is committed to your health and uses only the best equipment that technology has to offer. Medical Park Imaging has on-site physicians who are certified in radiology. Medical Park Imaging supports high school sports in Sussex and Morris counties. Medical Park Imaging with three locations, Wayne, Denville, and Newfoundland. This game is being sponsored in part by the best diner in Sussex County, the Double S Diner on Route 23 in Wantage, where the portions are huge and the prices are small.
Hi, my name is Dr. Robert DeFalco. I'm an orthopedic surgeon from the Orthopedic Institute of New Jersey. The Orthopedic Institute of New Jersey is a complete musculoskeletal practice. We have board-certified physicians who specialize in the operative and non-operative treatment of any musculoskeletal problem.
We try to evaluate, educate, and treat the patient. Here we utilize a multidisciplinary approach, taking full advantage of the wonderful orthopedic, pain management, spinal care, and physical therapy professionals at the practice.
We have a very large practice with a number of different doctors with many different subspecialties, and it's an incredible asset.
The expertise of our physicians and the professionalism of our staff is what I believe sets our practice apart. This allows us to provide timely, personalized, high-quality care to our patients.
I take particular pride in knowing that the patient is well cared for and that their experience at the Orthopedic Institute of New Jersey has either met or exceeded their expectations. It's very rewarding seeing patients get back to their active lifestyle.
The team here at the Orthopedic Institute is outstanding. Without this team, I would have never made this team. And I mean that with every fiber of my being.
At the Orthopedic Institute of New Jersey, we believe you don't need to travel to receive world-class care. We have four major locations, including Hackettstown, Roxbury, Newton, and Sparta, and multiple satellite locations serving northern New Jersey and eastern Pennsylvania.
A longtime staple in Sussex Borough is Lorenzo's Pizza. Great Italian food, huge sub sandwiches, great pizza. Open 7 days a week. Lorenzo's Pizza. Come on by for lunch or dinner, or call your order in and pick it up. It'll be ready when you get there. Lorenzo's Pizza is a big supporter of high school sports in Northwest New Jersey, and they welcome all athletic teams to order from them. Lorenzo's Pizza, 973-875-5055.
And we're back after that big win from Perry Mayo at 132 pounds at 138. We're going to have Mike Callahan from Kittatinny, 17-11, against Shane Kovas, 15-7 for High Point. Your thoughts on this match, Nick?
Wow. Johnny Gardner is going to see Perry Mayo in his nightmare. Perry Mayo had a huge win last year. He just comes up big in the High Point matches.
Well, that's what rivalries do. It brings out the best of both teams. Callahan's a tough kid, but basically High Point kind of needs to get bonus here no matter what.
Absolutely, and they would be heavily favored here.
Callahan, a tough kid, a program kid, 17-11. Nick, you're familiar with those type of kids. They might not be superstars, but they become very serviceable wrestlers when they become juniors and seniors.
They do, and Callahan's a good athlete.
Yeah.
He's a kid, he played football as a freshman. Then as a sophomore, he went out for soccer, became the starting goalie on the varsity boys soccer team. He had an excellent year this year as well. He's a tough kid, but Kovas would be a clear favorite here.
Well, no score, but we've seen clear favorites not come through tonight. So
or not get bonus points sometimes.
Exactly.
And that, or as many bonus points. There is no one in this High Point crowd that thought Billy Talmadge would lose to Perry Mayo.
And Kovas will pick up the two. Well, it all started with Mafaro going out against Rutter and sticking him for the pin. High Point came back with some victories, had a 16-6 lead, but now it's down to a one-point lead, 16-15, as we're in match number 8 of 14 right now.
And this is where High Point needs to build on that lead. Their favorites here, 145. Trey Osborne beat Cal Brook in the HWS, but it was, I believe, a one-point match. So that's going to be a tough one. I think Calvin Brooks actually wrestling better now than he was earlier in the season.
Excuse me, Nick.
That's okay. Then you're going to hit 152s, and, you know, you got, like, a kid on Kittatinny that Casey Holtz, he's a funk master. He's, like, not at the same overall wrestling ability as the Scrivanis, but similar in that he's so funky. And if you fall asleep for a second, you're going to find yourself on your back when you wrestle him. So it doesn't get any easier. Then you got Shane Smith, who's the HWS champion. You got Josh Heiler, who's third in the HWS. And then they finish up with Josh Klimek and the freshman, Jake Mufaro.
Callahan picking up the point there. 2-1 our score.
And nice stop. Kobus did a nice job of stopping that counter shot by Callahan.
One of the beauties of this match, anything can happen when High Point Kittatinny hit the mat.
Absolutely. And you know what? The shame of it is, one of these two great coaches every year is leaving with their head hanging, wondering how they didn't come through here, how they didn't come through there, what didn't they do right. Neither one of these coaches is going to leave here pointing a finger at their kids.
Right.
They're always going to be beating themselves up. That's what makes them great coaches.
Although a section title and a trip to Toms River will soften the blow for whoever loses.
You know, it will.
Just
and
soften
if,
it.
And if you can win a group title and the other one doesn't, it kind of helps you a little bit.
Right.
I've been on the winning end of this matchup, and I've been on the losing end. And I'd hate to say it, but you'd take this match and everything else the rest of the season is gravy. You never think that way once you get past it, but
right.
In hindsight, you do.
Good job by Callahan holding off Kobus for the moment. 23 seconds to go, second period. Kobus with the 2-1 lead, and he'll pick up the points.
Nice job by Kobus.
Get the reversal 4-1 lead. 5 seconds to go.
Of course, I'm a little greedy. When I was here, and through no contribution of mine, we were fortunate enough to win 6 consecutive group titles and 7 straight years we beat High Point. So we got the best of both worlds there for a little bit.
Absolutely. He's going to give him the point as Callahan gives it to him. So it'll be 5-1, Kobus. And this matchup has had some streaks, but the last few years it's been really dead even.
Absolutely. And just some phenomenal matches. I mean, my first year coaching, we had a tremendous win at High Point in 1994. Came down to heavyweight with Matt Lelak from Kittatinny being on his back and having to fight off being pinned, and he came back and won the match. Kittatinny beat High Point. Then High Point winning and getting Dan Farber from Kittatinny had a lead. He got put on his back in a tied match. Got put on his back again. He lost. High Point won by 1. I mean, we had a couple years in a row where just dogfight matches.
We got one right now. 16-15 our score, minute to go, third period.
I think we have blood time here.
Score is 7-2.
And this point where 1 minute to go, Kobus is going to need a takedown, let him up, takedown to get the 4-pointer. And, you know, John Gill is talking to Mike Callahan across the mat there. And the thing that's gotten Callahan in trouble is taking shots from too far out, and Kobus has been able to counter it. He might be better off. I know he's got the stall warning. He really might be better off not even shooting.
So check out the blood situation. We're going to take a break, folks. We'll be back with the final minute of this match.
With winter weather approaching, now is a good time to get your wiper blades inspected and replaced. To keep your windshield clear, and make it much easier to see from the snow glare. Give us a call at Tim's Auto, 973 875-6181. Thank you.
These highlights are sponsored by Up and Above Contractors, LLC, winner of the New Jersey Herald Reader's Choice Awards for Best Contractor Builder and Best Roofer. Visit their new showroom, 698 Route 206 in Andover. Up and Above Contractors. Give them a call, 300-0636, or visit upandabovecontractors.com.
The new paver driveway.
Jim! Relax. These are CST monocast one-piece pavers.
Some pavers only have a thin layer of color sealed on top. But with CST monocast pavers, the strength and color goes all the way through. The color won't wear away. So your CST pavers will look just as beautiful 20 years from now.
Unlike Jim.
CST pavers. Discover the difference.
Wingle Supply is your winter headquarters for salt, ice melt, or pellet fuel. Wingle Supply, located 755 Route 565 in Augusta, 973-875-7170.
This wrestling match is being sponsored by attorney and CPA Bill Kehoe, located on Route 206 in Branchville. Make sure you're up to date on all the latest tax law. Call Bill Kehoe today for all your tax law questions at 973-579-3390. The Russo family are proud owners of two local businesses. Visible Difference is located on Woodport Road in Sparta and is your hometown salon. You will really see the visible difference. A full-service hair, skin, and nail salon. Call for an appointment today, 973-729-4338. The best bagels in Sussex County are found at AMB Bagels Deli and Grill. Get a great hearty breakfast and lunch. Everything is homemade at A&B Bagels. Call your order or stop into A&B Bagels, located in Newton and Randolph. Call them 973-579-8777.
Furniture is a reflection of you, your personality, your lifestyle. Hi, I'm Jesse Rowe from Home Furniture Warehouse.
Celebrate the new year with savings at Home Furniture Warehouse. Shop our New Year's sale now through January 11th. Save 15% off floor models, save 10% off special orders. And with new clearance items added daily, our pricing and selection are worth falling for.
Stop by Home Furniture Warehouse in Newton, your local furniture savings destination for over 20 years.
Family Ford, your local hometown dealership on the Circle of Netcog. Family Ford supplies t-shirts for local high schools in Sussex and in Morris counties. Family Ford has a great selection of new and used cars and trucks. Become one of the family. Shop at Family Ford on the Netcong Circle in Netcong.
Hello, this is Father McHugh, president of Pope John High School. Pope John once said, "You are not here on earth to guard a museum, but to cultivate a flourishing garden of life." And for the past 60 years, Pope John High School has provided a warm and caring environment for our students, which strengthens faith, practices educational excellence, fosters individual growth, and maximizes each child's unique potential. Call Mrs. Kaiser, Director of Admissions, at 973-729-6125, extension 255, to schedule a visit and learn why so many families from Sussex, Morris, Passaic, and Warren counties choose Pope John. We look forward to welcoming you on our campus. We are closer than you think.
Medical Park Imaging is a multi-modality imaging center with three locations. Medical Park Imaging is committed to your health and uses only the best equipment that technology has to offer. Medical Park Imaging has on-site physicians who are certified in radiology. Medical Park Imaging supports high school sports in Sussex and Morris counties. Medical Park Imaging with three locations, Wayne, Denville, and Newfoundland. This game is being sponsored in part by the best diner in Sussex County, the Double S Diner on Route 23 in Wantage, where the portions are huge and the prices are small. A long-time staple in Sussex Borough is Lorenzo's Pizza. Great Italian food, huge sub sandwiches, great pizza. Open 7 days a week. Lorenzo's Pizza. Come on by for lunch or dinner, or call your order in and pick it up. It'll be ready when you get there. Lorenzo's Pizza is a big supporter of high school sports in Northwest New Jersey, and they welcome all athletic teams to order from them. Lorenzo's Pizza, 973-875-5055.
And we're back here at Kittatinny High School. 7-2 our score. Shane Kobus with the 5-point lead over Mike Callahan, 138 pounds.
Kobus is going to need to work now. He's going to need two takedowns. Callahan's going to have to watch getting dumped here. Kobus got that elbow deep. He's able to fight it off with the quarter Nelson. And that's the point. You know, that's really smart by Callahan. Take that little shot on the edge there. Worst comes to worst, gun abounds. Ref sees you doing the work. You buy yourself maybe 10 more seconds before you get a stalling call. Remember, Kobus got that stalling call in the first.
Yes.
Callahan on deep. And he's going to get a takedown.
Great job by Callahan. 7-4. 20 seconds to go. See if Callahan can make this closer or possibly get a turn here, but I think he's going to run out of time.
I think Kittatinny will be more than happy to only give up 3 points here.
And Kobus is going to post a 7-4 decision over Callahan as High Point will go up 19-15 as we go to 145. It's Cal Brook for Kittatinny.
And Trey Osborne for High Point.
And Osborne will come out for Kittatinny. Trey Osborne 12-9, Cal Brook 19-7. Another one of those toss-up matches here.
And High Point absolutely needs it because they're already going to need a win up here that maybe they're going to need to win toss-up bouts here because they got a couple bouts coming up where they do not match up well. If Kittatinny gets to 182 and only needs to win one more bout, we're going to see Josh Klimek at 182 against McDonald. And High Point doesn't want it to get to that point because that's a bad matchup for them. So they got to win here and they've got to win another match yet. And then hope that McDonald can wrestle the freshman, Jake Mafaro, and come up with something.
Go off the edge of the mat. We'll come back into the middle. So the chess game, well, the chess game began when this,
it's beginning of the year. Everything's playing. It's right in front of you. Now you know what you're doing the rest of the way. You get to 182, High Point's going to have to come out first, so Kittatinny's going to get whatever matchup they want. If you said to Kittatinny, well, let's just move it to 182 and you just need to win one bout to win the match, John Gill would sign up with that for that in a second. But, you know, Osborne won this matchup the last time they wrestled, and he's a tough kid. If this match is close late, he's always going to be in good position. Brooks got to win this match on the feet, and Osborne wants to win this match on the mat. If he can take Brooke down, he's in good position because he's very good on the mat.
Good job by Brooke to fight that off. 20 seconds ago. First period, no score as of yet. And first period is going to come to an end with no score. We'll move to the second period. Osborne will be down. Brook up top. And Nick, you know you're in the building. He's one of a long line of terrific athletes the Brooks have produced.
Yeah, and still another one coming. There's his freshman sister, Ava Brook.
Yes.
Excellent soccer player, basketball player.
Matt Micah told me, he goes, I'm so happy I'm going to plant her at sweeper for the next 4 years.
They have a great freshman class of girls soccer players. And they have an eighth grader that if they can get her to stay here, that program's going to be real tough.
Well, 1-0 our score. Osborne picked up the neutral. 1:23 to go
And you'll see two different styles here. Osborne's really trying to get Brooke to make a mistake and score off a counter. And Brooke's going to try and initiate offensively. Right now, Brooks is attacking very straight on, which plays into what Osborne does well.
Brooke in, but Osborne holding him off. 35 seconds to go, second period.
And Osborne on the counter here.
No points.
Nope. Good call by the official. He's patient and let it work itself out.
Nice little scramble at the edge of the mat.
The best officials are patient. If it's two right now, it's going to be two. 2 seconds from now. Let it play itself out. Don't be in a rush to give points. That was a great job.
Under 30 seconds go, second period. Trey Osborne with the 1-0 lead over Cal Brook. A big match. Well, they're all big when these two get together, but a key match, I'll call it. As we start to head into the home stretch, as this is match number 9 of 14. And the period's gonna come to an end with Osborne holding the 1-0 lead. We'll head to the third period. Brooke Cal will be Brooke, down.
Yep, he'll take bottom. And he's gonna have to move quickly because Osborne's very good on top. And nice Brooke. Leg block by Brooke and the shot.
Looking for the switch.
He gave a reversal, he didn't give an escape.
So he'll give the two to Brooke.
Yeah. And Brooke's going to stand Osborne up, so we'll get the same end result.
We're tied at two, 1:45 to go, third period.
Smart choice by Brooke. Very smart choice. You don't want to wrestle Osborne on the mat. We saw that in Lenape match earlier this year where he got a huge reversal to win.
Brooke trying to get control here.
Trying to snap down to a front headlock.
.110 to go, and we'll head back to the middle. Again, I want to thank attorney CPA Bill Kehoe. Tax season, give Bill a call, 973-579-3390. Garden State Coy, the Smith family, the Fall Guys, cleanup. Paul Stanzi Al owns that company, 973-221-3331. Wingle Supply, call them at 875-7170. Let's see who will win this battle of the wills.
Wow, tremendous shot by Calvin Brooke to get out of that. He was in a lot of trouble twice. He was in trouble on the shot, he was in trouble on the tie-up off of the shot, and he was able to fight out both times.
We've seen that several times tonight from Kittatinny guys. They look like they're in trouble, and they're able to fight it off. Finally, I want to thank Bill Moynihan of Stiefel Investments in Suckasauna, 973-598-8300. Bill wishes the Cougars the best of luck tonight and the rest of the season. 20 seconds to go. We're tied at 245 pounds.
And both guys have been in deep on shots. Neither one's been able to finish. Brooke was the closest with that reversal, which was almost a one and a two situation.
But we're 3 seconds away from going to sudden victory. And that's exactly where we are headed. 1 minute sudden victory.
We've seen a few of these lately.
Sparta did a great job the other night. The score might not have indicated, but they wrestled Pope John as tough as they could.
Absolutely. I think they were overmatched, and kids really raised their level.
Edge of the mat will come back.
Both of them are doing a lot of fighting up high. The first guy that drops to the hip is going to be the one that wins that situation if it comes up again. They've both been struggling up high. One of them gets smart and lowers his level. He's going to get the takedown and win.
Tied at 2:30 seconds to go, sudden victory.
Oh, Osborne was close there. He just wasn't able to grab the leg.
Good job by Cal Brook.
Cal Brook really trying to work this front headlock. Has not gotten Osborne really down to the match. He's going to have to watch feeding him the leg like that.
5 seconds.
He's going to try a Merkel here. A nice job by Osborne.
Big takedown by Trey Osborne. He will win the match in sudden victory. 4-2, a much needed win for the Wildcats as they will go up 22-15. Great job. As you mentioned, we saw against Lenape Valley pull out a win late. Oh, they had to go another minute, but he still got the job done.
And I said against in the Sparta match, I didn't say it tonight. In sudden victory, more matches are lost than won. And Cal Brook tried to force something that really wasn't there. And Osborne took advantage of it. And he dropped his level and was able to bring Brook to the mat. As we meet Trevor Kosher and
Casey Hotz.
Yep, Casey Hotz.
Hotz, excuse me. Kosher comes in with a record of 6-7. Casey Hotz, a record of 16-7.
And these are two guys you talk about, or you've talked about earlier, like the program guys.
Right.
And Casey Oates was a starter as a 113-pounder as a freshman. In and out of the lineup the last couple years, back in again as a regular starter here in his senior year. He's gotten a lot bigger and a lot stronger. It's made him a much more effective wrestler. And Kosher's just been a kid that you never really knew of, but he's getting it done in the room.
Hotz will take the 2-0 lead.
As I said, Hotz is a pinner.
I like how you described him. Funky. Like the Scrivanis. They get you at any time.
But sometimes you can put yourself in danger, too.
Kosher will pick up the escape 2-1-R score. Match number 10 as we move our way closer to what Nick had said before, and we'll see how things shake out at 182. And Kosher picking up the two.
And nice job there. And he did a nice job getting long and following that roll. If he doesn't shoot his legs back and follow that roll, he's going to end up on his back. Sort of a modified Granby by Hotz. Yeah, nice shot by Kosher.
So the first period will come to an end. Excuse me, the second period comes to an end with Kosher with the 3-2 lead.
First period.
Excuse me, first period. Check that.
Sorry. They switched numbers on you.
I'm new to all those numbers things.
Al Pellucci's quick over there. And you would have thought coaching freshman girls basketball, he wouldn't be in, you know, midseason clock form, but he's showing us.
Al, terrific at what he does, also one of the best tennis coaches around, the great Al Pellucci. So second period. Kosher working hard up top.
Really riding tough right now. Looking to stack up Hotz.
Fans calling for the stall warning.
High Point wanted their fans wanted the stall call when the kids got off the bus.
As we approach a minute to go here in the second period, Travis Kosher with the 3-2 lead over Casey Hotz.
And nice switch. He's going to get two and one maybe here. Lazy hips by Hotz, though. He's going to get one for a locked hands. He might get an escape now as well.
Right now he has the locked hands, and He gives them the escape as well, as Nick predicted.
Right.
So 4-3 our score. So Casey Hoats with 25 seconds to go in the second period has retaken the lead 4-3. Coach has to fix his headgear, more like a blindfold right now.
Those always hurt when you pull those off.
A little bit of a veteran move. Hoats listening to see what Johnny Gardner was going to say to his wrestler. What's the protocol? Is that like stealing signs?
Nothing wrong with it at all. Of course, your own coach usually upset. You're not looking at him.
Great point. Second period will come to an end. Hoats has the 4-3 lead over Travis Kocher, 152 pounds. Up top, Hoats trying to control Kocher.
And again, a match to High Point. They can get this match here. They feel really good. Then you got Eric Wingo coming up, and I know he's wrestling Shane Smith, but, you know, Wingo's wrestled in these big matches so many times.
I'm interested to see how he reacts after losing to Jonathan Borgannoni the other night. He hasn't wrestled in a match since, so that'd be interesting. But we have blood time here.
These highlights are sponsored by Up and Above Contractors, LLC, winner of the New Jersey Herald Reader's Choice Awards for Best Contractor Builder and Best Roofer. Visit their new showroom, 698 Route 206 in Andover. Up and Above Contractors. Give them a call, 300-0636, or visit upandabovecontractors.com.
Fall Guys, professional pest control, household lawn and landscape plants. Let the Fall Guys make your lawn clean and green. The Fall Guys can get rid of those nasty insects and mice in your home. Yuck! Make your home comfortable inside and out with the Fall Guys. Lawn service and pest control, serving all of Sussex, Morris, and Warren counties with the best and honest service. For more information, go to fallguys.com. Call the Fall Guys today, 973-221-3331.
The new paver driveway.
Jim, relax. These are CST monocast one-piece pavers.
Some pavers only have a thin layer of color sealed on top. But with CST monocast pavers, the strength and color goes all the way through. The color won't wear away. So your CST pavers will look just as beautiful 20 years from now.
Unlike Jim.
CST pavers. Discover the difference.
Wingle Supply is your winter headquarters for salt, ice melt, or pellet fuel. Wingle Supply, located 755 Route 565 in Augusta, 973-875-7170.
This wrestling match is being sponsored by attorney and CPA Bill Kehoe, located on Route 206 in Branchville. Make sure you're up to date on all the latest tax law. Call Bill Kehoe today for all your tax law questions at 973-579-3390.
This game is being sponsored by Highland State Bank, your local community bank. Visit their Sparta branch on Sparta Avenue in Sparta. Start that college fund today at Highland State Bank, Equal Housing Lender, member FDIC.
Furniture is a reflection of you, your personality, your lifestyle. Hi, I'm Jesse Rowe from Home Furniture Warehouse.
Celebrate the new year with savings at Home Furniture Warehouse. Shop our New Year's sale now through January 11th. Save 15% off floor models, save 10% off special orders. And with new clearance items added daily, our pricing and selection are worth falling for.
Stop by Home Furniture Warehouse in Newton, your local furniture savings destination for over 20 years.
Medical Park Imaging is a multimodality imaging center with three locations. Medical Park Imaging is committed to your health and uses only the best equipment that technology has to offer. Medical Park Imaging has on-site physicians who are certified in radiology. Medical Park Imaging supports high school sports in Sussex and Morris counties. Medical Park Imaging with three locations, Wayne, Denville, and Newfoundland. This game is being sponsored in part by the best diner in Sussex County, the Double S Diner on Route 23 in Wantage, where the portions are huge and the prices are small.
Hello, this is Father McHugh, president of Pope John High School. Pope John once said, "You are not here on earth to guard a museum, but to cultivate a flourishing garden of life." And for the past 60 years, Pope John High School has provided a warm and caring environment for our students, which strengthens faith, practices educational excellence, fosters individual growth, and maximizes each child's unique potential. Call Mrs. Kaiser, Director of Admissions, at 973-729-6125, extension 255, to schedule a visit and learn why so many families from Sussex, Morris, Passaic, and Warren counties choose Pope John. We look forward to welcoming you on our campus. We are closer than you think.
Hi, my name is Dr. Robert DeFalco. I'm an orthopedic surgeon from the Orthopedic Institute of New Jersey. The Orthopedic Institute of New Jersey is a complete musculoskeletal practice. We have board certified physicians who specialize in the operative and non-operative treatment of any musculoskeletal problem.
We try to evaluate, educate, and treat the patient. Here we utilize a multidisciplinary approach, taking full advantage of the wonderful orthopedic, pain management, spinal care, and physical therapy professionals at the practice.
We have a very large practice with a number of different doctors with many different subspecialties, and it's an incredible asset.
The expertise of our physicians and the professionalism of our staff is what I believe sets our practice apart. This allows us to provide timely, personalized, high-quality care to our patients.
I take particular pride in knowing that the patient is well cared for and that their experience at the Orthopedic Institute of New Jersey has either met or exceeded their expectations. It's very rewarding seeing patients get back to their active lifestyle.
The team here at the Orthopedic Institute is outstanding. Without this team, I would have never made this team. And I mean that with every fiber of my being.
At the Orthopedic Institute of New Jersey, we believe you don't need to travel to receive world-class care. We have four major locations, including Hackettstown, Roxbury, Newton, and Sparta, and multiple satellite locations serving northern New Jersey and eastern Pennsylvania.
A longtime staple in Sussex Borough is Lorenzo's Pizza. Great Italian food, huge sub sandwiches, great pizza. Open 7 days a week. Lorenzo's Pizza. Come on by for lunch or dinner, or call your order in and pick it up. It'll be ready when you get there. Lorenzo's Pizza is a big supporter of high school sports in Northwest New Jersey, and they welcome all athletic teams to order from them. Lorenzo's Pizza, 973-875-5055.
So we will start again here at 152. Casey Hoats with the 4-3 lead. And Travis Kocher, did he get the flags? He gets two.
Casey Hoats got two flags.
So that was green, excuse me. So 6-3, Hoats with the lead. And he's got Kocher in trouble again. And he'll add to his lead. 9-3.
If he can get another turn, it becomes a major decision.
Seconds, plenty of time for him.
The Hoats is getting sloppy with his hips. He's got to watch the coacher doesn't hip across when he drops a hip down for the cradle. And he could be on his back.
20 seconds. 9-3 lead.
He's going to look for a quick tilt here. Coacher's got to be careful. He's fighting so hard for the reversal. He doesn't want to leave himself in danger.
So Casey Hoats coming out on fire here in the third period. He had a 4-3 lead. Now it's 9-3. 12 seconds.
And coach, you're listening to Coach Johnny Gardner said, hey, just keep a wide base. Keep a wide base. Whatever you do, don't put yourself in danger. The Hawks was losing 3-2, but it came back with a nice win.
9-3 with the victory for Kittatinny. It makes it 22-18, correct?
Right.
As we'll move to 160.
Shane Smith.
And Eric Wingle, let's see if he comes out.
No, it is not Eric Wingle.
It is not.
Sawyer Fenlon.
So Sawyer Fenlon will come out for High Point. So we'll see Wingle at 170, most likely against just Josh Eiler.
If Wingle's available. Now, he's warming up. We never know.
Well, if he's available, what are your thoughts?
Well, you're doing the math, and you're thinking, we got to win two more matches. You know, you bump him against Hyler. Smith is dangerous. He not only wins, you make a mistake and he pins you. He pins Kittatinny, takes the lead. The move could backfire.
Sawyer Fenlon out there.
I never get the decisions wrong sitting over here.
Absolutely, you're undefeated. Sawyer Fenlon 2-3. Shane Smith 22-6. And as we pointed out, he beat Reese Muldoon of Pope John to win the HWS title at 160. Sawyer coming off a terrific soccer season. No points yet. And there's two.
He had a hand on the mat, so he definitely should have had the two.
Sawyer Fenlon.
Locked hands.
And we'll have the locked hands. Smith will pick up the point. Sawyer's dad, the soccer coach, boys soccer coach, also does a great job with the TV department at High Point. He's actually up top live streaming right now and holding two cameras. He's filming his boy and filming for the live stream.
He's doing a little more work than Jordan Catelli.
Fenlon put on some weight. He's a lot stronger than he's been in the last few years. You can see physically he's bigger.
Shane Smith trying to get the escape here. And he does.
We're tied at two. We have 10 seconds to go, first period.
Shane Smith put himself in a lot of trouble there.
Works
he
his
is
way
fortunate
out.
To get out of that.
And the period will come to an end, tied at two. Sawyer Fenlon, with only six matches under his belt this year, a guy with a little bit more mat time might have taken advantage of that. So second period, tied at two. Sawyer Fenlon, a High Point. HWS champion Shane Smith of Kittatinny. Smith trying to turn Fenlon. .25 to go second period. Smith trying to turn him.
Trying to work that back hook. Fenlon doing a nice job hugging the mat with his hips.
There's a stall warning. And we'll head back to the middle of the mat. Tied at 2. 47 seconds to go, second period. Obviously, Kittatinny the favorite here, but Sawyer Fenlon doing a nice job for the Wildcats.
Absolutely. Leaving himself in position to win this match. Shane Smith getting a little sloppy with his hips. He's got to be careful. He's going to work at that cross arm right here. He's going to walk that around the head if he can.
He's got the time. 16 seconds, plenty of time. He's got Fenlon in trouble. Shane Smith gets the pin.
Huge pin.
And Kittatinny will take the lead 24-22. Shane Smith with a huge pin for the Cougars.
And we will get Eric Wingle and Josh Heiler.
We move to 170 pounds. And Kittatinny takes a 2-point lead. The fall in 355 for Shane Smith. Heiler comes into this match with a record of 22-5, third place at the HWS. Eric Wingle, 17-7. But as we said before, coming up a tough loss to Jonathan Borgannoni of Newton. We'll see how he responds. His Wildcats need a good response. As Nick has pointed out in the matches we've done before with High Point, Eric Wingle's been there, done that in the big matches, so we'll see what he does here as we'll head back to the middle of the mat. So we're at match 12 of 14, and the match still in the balance. No surprise there, right?
No, not at all.
Stating the obvious coming in.
Yeah. And Heiler with the dump for a takedown. Now, Josh Heiler, we actually saw him 2 years ago as a freshman. He wrestled a really tough match. He said he had a really bright future. And last year, just couldn't find his way into lineup on a regular basis. And I think this year, he's in the lineup. He's a lot stronger. And you can just see a level of confidence about him right now. But Eric Wingle, there isn't a kid in this gym that's wrestled in more big matches than Eric Wingle has.
Under a minute to go, first period. Heiler with the 2-1 lead over Wingle, 170 pounds. Kittatinny has just taken a 2-point lead, 24-22. Big pin by Shane Smith in 355 over Sawyer Fenlon. So Kittatinny has the lead for the first time since the pin that started this match with Zach Mafaro decking Cliff Rutter at 220. And the period will come to an end.
Well, and part of why High Point made this move was they needed, I think they're going to take McDonald out of their lineup. Because then Sabo's going to go up at 182. So I think no matter what happens here, we're going to see Josh Clement come out at 182.
And as Nick pointed out, a very pivotal match. And picking up the escape there. They're tied at 2. Wingle and Heiler. Thank you. Wiggle tries the shot. Heiler backs off. Wiggle tries again. We'll start hearing the stalling calls pretty soon. We'll see how, as we said, Wingle responds against a quality opponent in Hyler. Less than a minute to go, second period. And we'll head back to the middle of the mat. Take this time to thank Wingle Supply. Big support of High Point Wrestling. Call them today, 973-875-7170. Shot taken there by Hyler, but nothing doing. 35 seconds to go, second period. And there's the stall warning. Wiggle trying for the throw, but again, Hyler ready for it.
Hyler's got to open up a little bit more, create some opportunities. Wingle's tough from the tie-up. He's able to stifle a lot of things that you're going to want to do, and he's going to set himself up for moves like that. Hyler gets on his toes, he would have had him.
And no points awarded. Remain tied at two. And the period will come to an end tied at two. And we head to the third period. One match tonight went to sudden victory.
Nyler taking feet here. You know, High Point, listen, they still have Sabo going at 182, and they're going to have Flores versus, most likely, I would think, the freshman, Jake Mafaro, at 195.
So the wheels have been turning for a while to set up these matchups. We're as close as you can get.
Of course, it really depends on them getting this match. And that stalling's going to give Wingle the lead.
Picks up the penalty point. He takes a 3-2 lead. 1:30 to go, third period.
And that's what Hyler's got to go in the offensive. Now he needs the takedown to not lose. Before, he could look at, well, maybe I go to sudden victory. No, you can't do that now. You got to set it up. And now that puts Wingle in a good position because he's excellent at countering the mistakes. If Hyler forces, Wingle's going to get a big takedown.
We'll have a stalemate. Head back into the middle.
Now, Tyler doesn't want to be crazy here,
right,
and force something where he puts himself in a position to get pinned, but he's got to work forward. Wingle is just wrestling a great match right now.
He certainly is. He's risen to the occasion thus far. Again, Hyler, a quality wrestler. High Point fans looking for a stall.
Neither of them is doing anything. And Wingle's smart. I'm just going to sit here and wait for you to shoot on me. And if
right.
you make a mistake, I'm going to pancake you.
Absolutely.
Hyler's got to work in. He's working from too far out. And Wingle's just playing this match great right now.
It's the mental part of the match. Everyone thinks it's all about the strength of the moves. But you got to be smart.
Yeah, and Wingle's been very smart. And you can see, he's creating distance to make Hyler's work from far away. And now he'll get a stalling.
So he'll get the stall warning with 8 seconds to go. See if Wingle can hold on. He has a 3-2 lead.
It's a nice win.
So Eric Wingle bounces back, picks up a big win over Hyler. And High Point will retake the lead 25-24. And we go to 182.
And Jake Mafaro will come out for Kittatinny.
The freshman, Jake Mafaro.
And this will be McDonald.
McDonald will come out. So Jake Mafaro, the freshman, he has a record of 14-7 in the veteran senior, Matt McDonald. He is 8-10. So very interesting. McDonald going to go out there against the freshman, a veteran. So huge match here at 182 with one match to go, and Mafaro with the takedown.
By the way, remember I was raving about what an athlete Zach Mafaro is?
Right.
The second best athlete in the gym right now, or 1A, is Jake Mafaro. He is a tremendous athlete, and he is very, very strong. He's not built like a freshman.
He is not. And he's got McDonald in trouble.
Yes, he does.
Turns him to his back. McDonald fights it off. Mafaro again. Trying to turn McDonald. He might. Nope. McDonald fights it off.
He's got his head too high. He's got to get his head in the hip. McDonald doing a great job of just fighting. Jake either has to raise that knee, and actually I think he might try to stack the knee here. He wasn't able to get any back points there.
No, not at all. 39 seconds to go. Even if one of the other team, if Kittatinny does get six here, match still not over. And that sets up 195, Nick.
It does, but with Kittatinny's best, second best upper weight.
Again, Mafaro locking up McDonald. He gets the pin.
Huge win for the freshman.
And Kittatinny will push its lead to 30-25 as we come down to the final match of the night with a 5-point lead. With a fall in 142. And let's see. Here out comes Klimek.
And a forfeit.
Wow, High Point will forfeit the last match of the night to Klimek, and Kittatinny will win back-to-back wins over High Point with a 34, no, that should be
30 to 25. Wait, 36-25, right.
Yeah, 36-25, scoreboard coming up short. So congratulations to Kittatinny, final score. 36-25, another one in the books. Kittatinny will cut its deficit to 27-14-1 in this long-standing series. Nick, real quick, your thoughts.
I just think Kittatinny, their kids stepped up. They had no disrespect to High Point. They got some big wins. I thought Tom Hubmaster came up big for them, but wow, Perry Mayo, huge job. And guys like Mike Nelson, who avoided giving up a tech fall and a pin. Shane Smith with a big pin. The pin from the freshman, Jake Mafaro. What a great match.
It certainly was. And again, I want to thank all of our sponsors for helping sponsoring this match. Now both of these teams will look towards the state tournament. They're the top seeds in their section. Kittatinny North 1, Group 1. High Point North 1, Group 2. Kittatinny will move to 15-4, High Point will fall to 13-5. That'll wrap it up here from Kittatinny. For Gina Barbagallo on the numbers, our cameraman Jordan Catelli, my partner Nick DeGennaro. I'm Dan Cleary. We'll see you again soon here on Channel 10 and MugsMedia.com.